Hi there, my name is Dan, and this is a free extract from my larger InDesign course on my website, bringyourownlaptop.com. Hi, in this video, we're going to look at what happens when you open up somebody else's document and it says, dun dun, you're missing fonts. There's missing images as well, but we do that in an earlier video. I'm going to close this down. Okay, and you'll also notice that goes this horrible pink color for anything that is missing. So let's go and do that in our tutorial. Okay, so in this video, we've been sent a file by somebody, but the fonts have come up missing fonts. So if you're following along with the exercise files, open up O2 existing work, open up Green at Heart prospectus, and it says missing links, which we did in a previous video, so go check that one out. But now we're going to deal with this one, missing fonts. Now, this can be a super easy fix, or this can be super complicated. Super easy means it's a font that actually exists on Adobe's Typekit. Typekit is the name that Adobe calls its font library. And what can happen is it can load up and it senses you don't have that font in your machine, but it says, hey, I found Roboto Slab Lite on Typekit, and because you're a Creative Cloud member and awesome, would you like me to download it and install it for you? Okay, and you can click sync fonts and life is good. Where life is harder, it's when it has no syncing here and it says I cannot find it anywhere. So what you need to do is you need to click on this find fonts. Okay, it's going to tell you, in our case, it's Roboto Slab Lite that's missing. Okay, and what we can do, I can click sync fonts here because it's on Typekit, but you might not have that option. Often it's not. So what you need to do is do one of two things. You can replace it with something else, okay? Because sometimes if you're working across Mac and PC, say somebody's used Times New Roman. Times New Roman is what a PC calls Times New Roman. A Mac, for some reason, calls it Times. Okay, same font, same attributes. So you might have to go and say, actually, Roboto Slab, I'm going to go into my list. Okay, this is the list that are on my computer and find it. And it might just have, it might be the pro version. So you might have Roboto Pro or something slightly different. Okay, and you can go and replace it. And you keep an eye on it and see if the font changes. It might be exactly the same. Or you might have to go through and say, I don't have Roboto Slab, so I'm just going to use Arial. Okay, and I'm going to hit change all. Okay, and it's going to go through and switch out every use of Roboto for Arial. And that's a sad day because Roboto Slab is nice and Arial is not nice. Another thing you could do is actually just ignore this. Hit done, don't care about it, and it's gonna go this big kind of pink color. I know where it is there. Okay, so I've got W on, off, okay, and it goes this kind of horrible pink outline color. Say I'm just doing a text check. Okay, I've sent it to somebody and they're just doing a quick check of the text. They're missing the fonts, don't worry about it. Just leave it missing, send it back to the person who originally owned it, who does have the font, and it will come back to life. If that's still not fixing your problems, you're going to have to install the font. You'll get a package document from your designer or whoever made this. Okay, it'll be a zip file, and inside of it will be, let's have a look at an existing one I've got. Let's have a look at our desktop and InDesign class files. We made this package file earlier. Okay, so somebody might have sent you this, and inside of here is a documents font, and you might find, hey, there he is there. And all you need to do is double click it. And depending on what program you're on, I'm on a Mac, okay, and I can just click install font. Okay, if you're on a PC, it's a very similar process. What I've done for this class is in your exercise files, under missing footage, there's one called Roboto Slab, and here are all the fonts that we need. In this case, it's Roboto Slab Lite. If I go and install this one now, life should be okay. Go back in here, ha, sprung to life. If you don't have that font and it hasn't been sent to you, you're gonna have to probably buy it. Some fonts are free, lots of them aren't. If you're gonna go and buy it, I can recommend myfonts.com. This is where I buy my fonts. Fonts aren't cheap, or it depends. People put a lot of work into these fonts. So say that I need a font and I need to buy this vintage one that's been made. You can see here, this one here is gonna cost me 27 euros. Okay, bigger fonts. By that I mean it has a whole lot more characters and weights than you're gonna pay more. Okay, but this is a good place to go buy it. But there are plenty of other places. Pick whichever one works for you. Okay, so I hope one of those options helps you with finding a missing font. Let's get on with this tutorial series. So, what did you think? Did you like it? Okay, if you did, please hit the like button and maybe consider subscribing to my channel. It really helps my business. Now, this is just a free video from my larger InDesign course. You can see the full version on bringyourownlaptop.com. On that site, there is a free cheat sheet you can download. Okay, print it off, stick it next to your computer, look awesome. The other thing is I have lots of other courses there. Photoshop, Illustrator, InDesign, After Effects, Premiere, Dreamweaver, lots of other ones. So go check that out on bringyourownlaptop.com. Bye.